Dear students and dear viewers, I hope you are fine. Today I am going to cover reactions of carbonyl functional group, and this lecture is the part one of the reactions of aldehyde and ketones. Here are the topics which I am going to cover in this presentation. First of all, I will discuss nucleophilic addition reaction, some basic understanding, then addition of water and formation of hydrate of aldehyde and ketones. Then I will discuss addition of alcohol will result the formation of hemiacetal or acetal, or if alcohols are added on ketonic functional group then they generate hemiketal or ketal formation. Similar type of reaction could be seen by addition of mercaptans or thiose, that is the formation of hemithioacetal or thioacetal, hemithioketal and thioketal. Then I will talk about addition of cyanidine, formation of cyanohydrin. Then we will also discuss benzoin condensation reactions and limitations. Then we will end up this presentation with addition of amines and their derivatives, that is the formation of imine, oxime, hydrazone, semicarbazone. Then I will discuss the reactions which we will cover in the next lecture. I am grateful to the books, and I must acknowledge these three important books from where I have prepared this lecture: the book of organic chemistry from L.G. Wade, a book on named reactions by Laszlo Kurti and Barbara Zacho, and a guidebook to mechanism in organic chemistry by Peter Syk. Okay, class, regarding nucleophilic addition reactions, a nucleophile is going to add on carbonyl carbon. Actually, a strong nucleophile can easily attack on carbonyl group, carbonyl carbon that is, and it form an alkoxidine which is then protonated, and then a product is obtained. If we are having a weak nucleophile, then first of all protonation of carbonyl oxygen is carried out. This protonation increases the positive character of carbonyl carbon, and then a nucleophile can easily attack on carbonyl carbon. We should remember that aldehydes are more reactive than ketones. And however, there are several factors which are responsible to control the rate of reaction, including the nature of substituents, electron withdrawing or electron attracting group versus electron donating or electron releasing group. What happens if an electron withdrawing group is present with the carbonyl carbon? Actually, electron withdrawing group decreases the electron density on carbonyl carbon, results the formation of positively charged or more positive carbon, as a result of which a nucleophile can easily attack on carbonyl carbon. But if electron releasing or electron donating group is present along with carbonyl carbon, then the addition of a nucleophile is not easy, because electron donating group usually decrease the positive character by providing electrons to the carbonyl carbon. What about the steric hindrance? Definitely, greater the steric crowding, presence of bulky group, the slower will be the rate of reaction. What about size and nature of nucleophile? Definitely, a strong nucleophile can attack very easily on carbonyl carbon. And if the size of nucleophile is larger, then usually it can not easily attack on carbonyl carbon, depending on many other factors too. What about ring strain? Definitely, if carbonyl carbon are in cyclic form and they are bearing more ring strain, then attack of nucleophile is easier in order to compensate or to decrease the ring strain. So higher the or greater the reactivity of carbonyl compound, the greater will be the rate of reaction. Similarly, addition of acid or base, nature of solvents and temperature also play a vital and important role for the reaction of for addition of nucleophile on carbonyl carbon. Here you can see the attack of nucleophile on carbonyl carbon, shifting of electron towards oxygen resulting the formation of alkoxidine, then protonation either from solvent or from acid result the formation of our product. Basically, nucleophilic addition reactions to carbonyl group can be carried out either in the presence of a base or in the presence of an acid. what are the criteria for basic conditions? Actually, when there is a base, then a base can easily generate a strong nucleophile, and then this strong nucleophile can easily attack on carbonyl carbon, result the formation of an alkoxide. Here one important point I should mention here, the presence of a solvent like hydrogen bonding, you can see here, because of presence of water. If water is present in the reaction medium, then hydrogen bonding could be seen. Similarly, alcohol, presence of alcohol also responsible for hydrogen bonding. What is the role of this hydrogen bonding? Actually, hydrogen bonding increases positive character of carbonyl carbon, as a result of which our nucleophile can easily attack on carbonyl carbon. Okay, come to the point again. We are talking about the basic conditions, or basic condition results the formation or generation of a strong nucleophile. A strong nucleophile can easily attack on carbonyl carbon, resulting shifting of electron towards oxygen and formation of this type of alkoxide. Then the alkoxide is protonated either from solvent or from a weak acid, resulting the formation of product, addition product. The reaction is also reversible by deprotonation, which is followed by the loss of nucleophile. Removal of proton results the formation of starting material. Nucleophilic addition reactions under acidic conditions. If a nucleophile is weak nucleophile, then first step is actually protonation of oxygen of carbonyl functionality. This protonation of oxygen results the formation of this type of oxonium ion. Here you can see the resonance form of this oxonium ion. Now positive character of carbonyl carbon is higher. A weak nucleophile can easily attack on carbonyl carbon, resulting the shifting of bond or formation of desired product. Reaction is again reversible if there is a loss of weak nucleophile. You can see this is followed by the deprotonation. Class or viewers, now we are talking about addition of water under acidic conditions. Acid catalyzed hydration is a typical acid catalyzed addition to the carbonyl group. Protonation followed by addition of water gives a protonated product. Deprotonation gives the product which is actually a geminal diol or hydrate. We are talking about formation of hydrate of carbonyl compounds. You can see in the first step protonation, resulting the formation of oxonium ion. Then water, which is actually a weak nucleophile, can easily attack on carbonyl carbon, resulting the shifting of electron towards oxygen, and positive character of this oxygen is lost, is it neutralized. Then the loss of hydrogen either from water or from the counter ion of acid, that is X negative, resulting the formation of this type of hydrate. So this is the mechanism for acid catalyzed reaction, hydration. What about base catalyzed? In the presence of a base, water converts into hydroxide ion. A base abstract hydrogen from water. And base catalyzed hydration is a perfect example of base catalyzed addition to carbonyl group. So first step is addition of hydroxide ion on carbonyl carbon, resulting the formation of this type of alkoxide. Then protonation results the formation of this hydrate. Addition of water actually gives hydrate. If hydrate is generated from aldehyde or it is generated from ketone, there is different equilibrium. In aqueous solution, a ketone or aldehyde is in equilibrium with the hydrate, with its hydrate. With most ketone, the equilibrium favors towards unhydrated keto form. You can see here, this is a ketonic form or a ketonic compound. After hydration, result the formation of this hydrate. But you can see the arrow, direction of arrow towards the reactant side, and it tells the unhydrated, favoring the unhydrated ketonic form. We have already seen the acidic. In acidic condition, water acts as a nucleophile. In base condition, hydroxide of water acts as a nucleophile. And we also know that aldehydes are more electrophilic since they have fewer electron donating alkyl group. hydrates are stable and isolatable. This is a general fact. When hydrates are stable and isolatable, whenever they are bearing with or they contain an electron withdrawing group in their skeleton. Here you can see the we have already studied the formation of formalin, the aqueous solution of formaldehyde. We have seen here you can see hydrate of a ketonic compound, that is acetone. Okay class, regarding the concept of stability of hydrate, you can see here presence of two alkyl group, presence of one alkyl group and no alkyl group, strongly electron withdrawing substituents on alkyl group of a ketone or aldehyde also destabilize the carbonyl group and favors the hydrate formation. Chloral, for example, trichloroacetaldehyde, this is the structure of chloral, trichloroacetaldehyde. It has electron withdrawing trichloromethyl group, which favors towards hydrate formation. It allows the attack of water towards the carbonyl carbon, resulting in the formation of chloral hydrate. Here I am giving you a question that you have to first prepare hydrates of these four different compounds, right hydrates, and then discuss which hydrate is more stable and why. This is a short assignment. So we are moving towards next. We are talking about now the addition of alcohol. Addition of alcohol on aldehyde result the formation of either hemiacetal, if one molecule of alcohol is added, or formation of acetal, if two molecules of alcohol are added on aldehydic compound. Similarly, addition of alcohol on ketonic compound results the formation of hemiketal or ketal. Here you can see. Addition of thiol is similar as addition of alcohol, and addition of thiol on aldehyde results the formation, two moles of thiol results the formation of thioacetal, and addition of two molecules of thiol on ketonic carbonyl results the formation of thioketal. Mechanism is same, but the difference is in their stability. We are talking about the stability. Regarding mechanism of addition of alcohol or thiol, I am discussing here the reaction is acid catalyzed, and what happened when acid is added on carbonyl compound, we have already studied that hydrogen actually activate the carbonyl carbon by protonation of oxygen, and as a result of which a weak nucleophile can easily attack on carbonyl carbon. First of all, hemiacetal is formed, and then acid catalyzed, loss of water results the formation of acetal by addition of second molecule of alcohol. Reaction is reversible. Acetal or ketal, similarly thioacetal or thioketal are protecting group against base. They are protecting group of carbonyl against base. If we want a carbonyl carbon not to be attacked by a base, we can protect the carbonyl carbon either in the form of acetal, ketal, thioacetal or thioketal. Thioacetal or thioketal are relatively stable towards dilute acids as compared with acetal or ketal. We should remember one fact that sugars usually exist as their acetal or hemiacetal forms. Now we are discussing the mechanism of acetal or ketal formation. You can see the first step is protonation, addition of hydrogen or formation of oxonium ion or protonation of oxygen, which results the activation of carbonyl functional group. This carbonyl carbon is activated by protonation of oxygen. Now alcohol can easily attack on this carbonyl carbon, resulting the formation of this type of moiety. Then loss of hydrogen from alcohol. This hydrogen can be extracted either from the counter ion of acid or from solvent or even from alcohol, result the formation of this hemiacetal. Now protonation of another hydroxyl group results the formation of protonation results the formation of another oxonium ion, which after removal of water gives resonance stabilized carbocation. Here I am adding one more slide. You can see I am providing you another alternative route, that oxygen gives its oxygen of alkoxy group gives its electron towards carbonyl carbon, resulting removal of water and formation of this type of oxonium ion. This oxonium ion is resonance stabilized in this form, resonance stabilized carbocation. So after formation of hemiacetal, the second alcohol adds. Addition of second molecule of alcohol on carbonyl carbon, which is now positive, result the formation of this type of intermediate. Another oxonium ion is generated. Removal of hydrogen, either from the counter ion of acid or from solvent, that is alcohol, result the formation of acetal. Again, I am providing another alternative route. Electrons of oxygen gives its electron to the carbonyl carbon, resulting removal of water and formation of this type of activated carbon. Then addition of alcoholic molecule towards the carbonyl carbon, resulting the shifting of electron towards oxygen and formation of another oxonium ion. Then proton is lost from counter ion of acid or from the solvent, resulting the formation of acetal. I hope you understand this basic mechanism. There is reversibility of acetal or ketal into carbonyl form. You can see reversibility. In the presence of acid, first step is protonation of alkoxy group, resulting the formation of this oxonium ion. Then electrons of oxygen gives are provided towards the carbon, resulting removal of alcoholic molecule. And then addition of water towards the carbonyl carbon, resulting the formation of another oxonium ion. This one. Then abstraction of proton from water. Oxygen is oxygen of alkoxy group. Abstract proton from water, resulting the formation of this type of intermediate. And then electrons are provided from the oxygen of water, result removal of another alcoholic molecule, as a result of which this type of carbonyl species is generated. Reversibility of thioacetal or thioketal into carbonyl also follow the similar mechanism, and you can try this, right? Okay, what about cyclic acetal? Actually, first of all, I should recall one important point. The term acetal is more frequently used nowadays than ketal. And addition of diol produces a cyclic acetal. Instead of single alcohol, one can use dihydric alcohol, that is diol. It results the formation of cyclic acetal. Here you can see a carbonyl compound, addition of diol, resulting the formation of this type of cyclic acetal. Similarly, about cyclic thioacetal, addition of thiol, which is dihydric, resulting the formation of this type of cyclic thioacetal. You can also try to write mechanism in the similar way as I have described the mechanism previously. Now there is a question. If someone asks how one can convert this aldehyde carbonyl, aldehyde proton into replaced with deuterium ion, any idea? We have already studied that if we prepare acetal or cyclic acetal or carbonyl compound, then they are stable towards base. So first step will be protonation. First step will be protection of carbonyl in the form of acetal or thioacetal. You have to prepare the acetal or thioacetal of this one. Then by addition of a butyl lithium, which is a base, it will abstract proton from here, resulting the formation of carbene ion. And then addition of water, resulting the formation of deuterium. Then we can add acid under acidic conditions. The acetal or thioacetal will be converted back towards the carbonyl functional group, and this way we can prepare, we can do various modification in the structure too. Acetals as a protecting group, They are used very frequently in synthetic organic chemistry or in total synthesis of organic molecules as a protecting group. Here you can see one of the synthesis. If someone is going to prepare this molecule, starting from cyclohexane, hexanone, and this reagent, which is actually impossible reagent. This reagent is not easily prepared. So reaction is not easily prepared. This reactant is not easily prepared. So what happened? In actual synthesis, first step is protection of this aldehydic group. This aldehydic group is protected by using a diol, resulting in the formation of masked aldehyde. Now this aldehydic group is protected, and we can prepare its Grignard reagent. This Grignard reagent can easily attack on this carbonyl carbon, resulting in the formation of this species. After hydrolysis, one can prepare the desired target molecule. Similarly, here, this is a compound, and someone is asking to selectively reduce this aldehydic carbonyl using sodium borohydride. So one have to protect this aldehydic. If someone is selectively reducing the carbonyl group rather than aldehydic group, because sodium borohydride is more reactive towards aldehyde. So first step will be protection of aldehydic group, resulting the formation of this masked compound. Then by reduction, one can do reduction of carbonyl, ketonic carbonyl carbon, resulting the formation of this alcoholic compound. After hydrolysis, one can regenerate this protected group into carbonyl form. So hydrolyze easily in acidic conditions, and it is stable against base. So aldehydes are more reactive. We should remember aldehydes are more reactive than ketonic compounds. Similarly, here, this is the similar compound, and one have to prepare either this one, where we are going to add two molecules of Grignard reagent, resulting the formation of two diols under these conditions. But if someone wants to selectively do addition of Grignard reagent towards this ketonic carbonyl carbon, which is less reactive as compared with aldehydic carbonyl carbon, then what one have to do? We have to follow then another route. The another route is this one again. We have to do protection of this aldehydic carbonyl. Similar thing. Then addition of Grignard reagent is easy now here. You can see after hydrolysis, one can obtain this type of selective molecule. So here actually we have talked about chemoselectivity. Chemoselectivity means we are going to convert one functional group in the presence of another functional group. If there are two or more than two important functional groups are present in a molecule, and we are going to selectively change one functional group, then this is actually chemoselectivity. Here you can see two carbonyl groups were present, ketonic and aldehydic, and we wanted to reduce ketonic carbonyl in the presence of aldehydic carbonyl. Then we did this type of methodology. We followed this type of methodology. Class, now we are moving towards next topic, that is addition of hydrogen cyanide. Hydrogen cyanide is actually highly toxic, and it is generated either from sodium or potassium cyanide in acid, which generates hydrogen cyanide in situ. In situ means when it requires. Then a base is added which generates cyanide ion by abstraction of hydrogen. Then this cyanide ion can easily attack on carbonyl carbon, and protonation results the formation of cyanohydrin product. Cyanohydrin formation is actually poor in aromatic carbonyl compounds, and it is not observed in aromatic carbonyl compounds. And benzoin condensation is observed in benzaldehyde. We should remember the reactivity order of carbonyl compound, that formaldehyde are more reactive than aldehyde, and then ketones, and then bulky ketones. Here you can see the reaction, addition of hydrogen cyanide on the compound. What is the significance of cyanohydrin formation? Actually, after cyanohydrin formation, one can do various modification in cyanide group. Cyanide group after reduction resulting the formation of this amino compound. Hydroxy amino compound can be obtained. Similarly, hydrolysis of cyanide result the formation of alpha hydroxy assets. So this is the advantage here. It is also important to talk about 1,2 and 1,4 addition of cyanide ion on carbonyl functional group. If someone is going to use trimethyl silicon cyanide, then no benzoin condensation will be observed. Trimethyl silicon cyanide is a reagent which gives 1,2 addition on carbonyl group selectively, and this reagent makes very strong bond with oxygen, thus it favors 1,2 addition. Here you can see, one should remember that if starting material is alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, then 1,4 addition is dominated than 1,2 addition of hydrogen cyanide. This is alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compound, and addition of hydrogen cyanide in this case 1,4 addition is favorable. If someone wants to do 1,2 addition, then one have to change the reagent. Instead of hydrogen cyanide, one should use another reagent which makes stronger bond with oxygen, like here trimethyl silicon cyanide. Regarding benzoin condensation, if benzaldehyde is allowed to react with cyanide ion, then benzoin condensation is observed. The mechanism of reaction is here: attack of cyanide on electrophilic carbonyl carbon, resulting the formation of this type of ion. Then after abstraction of proton, resulting the formation of cyanohydrin. Removal of hydrogen from this cyanohydrin, resulting the formation of nucleophilic, resulting the formation of nitrile enolate. You can see here, loss of hydrogen resulting the formation of this type of moiety. This is nucleophilic. Here you can see nucleophilic carbon. Now this nucleophilic carbon attacks on the other molecule of benzaldehyde, result the formation of this condensation. Now hydroxide ion is neutralized by abstraction of hydrogen, resulting the formation of hydroxy group. A base again abstract proton from hydroxyl group, and it gives electron towards the oxygen, and oxygen gives its electron towards the carbon, which results the removal of cyanide ion and formation of alpha hydroxycarbonyl compound, that is benzoin here in this case. Formation of imine. Now we are talking about formation of imine. Nucleophilic addition of ammonia or primary amine followed by elimination of water molecule, and in this reaction a carbonyl converts into carbon double bond nitrogen, which is known as imine. You can see here addition of attack of nucleophilic nitrogen on carbonyl carbon, resulting the formation of this type of intermediate. Then hydroxide abstract proton from here, resulting the formation of this species, and then after removal of water, resulting the formation of carbon double bond nitrogen moiety or imine bond formation. It is also known as shift base. Loss of water is actually acid catalyzed, but acid also destroys the nucleophile like ammonia. So we have to be very careful if we are going to carry out this type of reaction, because it is also like reversible reaction. Acid catalyzed formation of imine or shift base. The mechanism here you can see, for the mechanism is more easy to remember if it is divided into two important parts. First part is acid catalyzed addition of amine to carbonyl group. First step is protonation of oxygen, resulting the formation of activated carbonyl carbon. On this carbonyl carbon, a nucleophile can easily attack. We have already studied about it, resulting the formation of this type of intermediate. Then abstraction of proton result the formation of this carbinol amine species. And in the second part, acid catalyzed dehydration, protonation of oxygen, resulting the formation of this oxonium ion, which is protonated form. Then you can see here, after removal of water, one can see this type of intermediate. Abstraction of hydrogen from this nitrogen, resulting the formation of imine species, which is also known as shift base, after the contribution of a scientist whose name was Schiff. Here you can see a variety of different condensation reactions based on amino group. that can be changed, either hydrogen or alkyl or hydroxy group or amino group or NH phenyl group or this one. Addition of ammonia results the formation of amine. Addition of primary amine results the formation of another type of amine. Then addition of hydroxyl amine results the formation of oxime. Addition of hydrazine results the formation of hydrazone. Addition of phenylhydrazine results the formation of phenylhydrazone. Addition of semicarbazide results the formation of semicarbazone. Here you can see the active site here in case of semicarbazide, this one, amino group, not this one, because lone pair of nitrogen can easily be shared with this carbonyl carbon, amide formation. You can see this is amide bond. So these lone pairs are not easily available to attack on carbonyl carbon. That is why a new bond is generated with this one, amino group, because lone pair are easily available to attack on carbonyl carbon. You can try to write the mechanism of you can also try to write the mechanism of all this. This way you can have a command on reaction mechanism. So far we have covered the topics: the nucleophilic addition reaction, basic understanding, addition of water, that is hydrate formation, addition of alcohol, formation of hemiacetal, acetal or hemiketal or ketal formation, addition of mercaptans or thiol, addition of cyanide, cyanohydrin formation, and significance of cyanohydrin formation like reduction and hydrolysis of cyanide group. But then we have discussed benzoin condensation, then addition of amine and their derivative, formation of imine, oxime, hydrazone and semicarbazone. What we are going to cover in next presentation, we are going to cover the following topics in next presentation, inshallah: reduction, Clemmensen and Wolff-Kishner reduction, Mirwin, Pondroff, Verley reaction, oxidation reactions, redox reactions, that is Cannizzaro reaction, condensation reactions including aldol condensation, actually the formation of enolates in condensation reactions, aldol reactions in amine formation, Nobinger reaction, Perkin reaction, stop condensation reactions, Claisen-Easter condensation, Mannich reaction, Reformansky reaction, Liquid reaction, Wittig reaction and some other named reactions, and then base catalyzed halogenation reactions. Till then I would say best of luck to all of you and good best wishes in your understanding and this class. Okay, take care.